Hi, this is Bob from Plugable Technologies. What I'd like to do today is give a quick overview of how you can change the audio settings in the Zoom video conferencing application. Now, what does that mean and why is it important? What I have here, or what you see on screen, is the desktop of my Dell laptop, which is connected to my Plugable UD3900 docking station. And the docking station has an audio output that you can plug speakers or headphones into. But the laptop also has built-in speakers and a headphone jack. There can be cases where when you use Zoom, you don't hear audio from your other participants in your meeting via the device that you wish, whether it be the laptop, built-in speakers, or headphones connected to the docking station. It can get a little confusing how to make these changes, so I wanted to go over first the general way that you can configure audio within Windows as a whole, and then within the Zoom application. So let's jump right in. There's always more than one way to do something in Windows, and in terms of changing which device audio routes out through, the typical easy way to change that is to come down here to the taskbar, click on the speaker icon, and you'll see that right now my default audio output setting is set to pluggable audio, which represents the pluggable UD3900 dock connected to my laptop. I can also click and make changes. I have one other device, this one that's called speaker/headphones Realtek high definition audio, it's truncated here, which represents the audio device built into my laptop. Let's change it to my laptop for a second so that I would hear sound out through my speakers in the laptop if I wanted to. Okay, that's one way to make changes in audio. Another way to make changes is to go start, the settings icon, system, and then sound. And this gives me a similar view, but with a little more information of what the default sound output device is. Right now, again, it's set to the built-in laptop output because I just changed it, and what your audio input device might be, including a microphone, which I'm using our pluggable USB Vox right now. But this is just for Windows as a whole. There can be cases where applications have their own specific audio settings. So let's look at that. Let me minimize the sound settings and let me bring up the Zoom application. I've launched the Zoom application. I'm not in a meeting, but that's okay. And you can access and make changes to the Zoom client by clicking on this little settings icon, the little gear up here in the upper right. If I click on that, you can see we have a bunch of different categories breaking out all the different settings, and one of them is audio. When I click on audio, it lists speaker and then shows me the different audio output options. Like right now it's set to pluggable audio. Well, hey, wait a minute. Why is that different than what I have here? I have speakers built and headphones built in my laptop as the default, but yet Zoom is showing something different. Well, that's okay, because it can be different depending on your preferences. There's no right or wrong way to do it. But let's say I don't want sound coming through my docking station. I can click and pick another option. In this case, though, we have three options. Before in Windows, when I clicked down in the taskbar, it was just two. I have speakers, pluggable audio, which again represents the docking station. I have speakers, headphones, Realtek high definition audio, which represents the audio device built in the laptop. But then also same as system. What same as system means is Zoom will take the default audio output device set for Windows as a whole and use it as a default as well. But again, it doesn't have to be that way. You can pick whatever you like. The important thing to remember is that whichever you prefer, if you don't hear audio in Zoom, you just have to pick whichever option you would prefer, whether it would be the built-in laptop, speakers, or headphones, or the pluggable audio device. So hopefully you find that useful, and thank you for watching.